Hey, it's me, MLB. Here is chapter 15 of Rapid Fate Online, and this one is titled, Is This Goodbye? Oh, a snakeskin. I could get lots of things made from snakeskin, you said excitedly. And 10 mahi. If I kill 10 snakes, I can make 100 mahi in a day. No time to celebrate now, On. There are more, Butterfly said calmly. You whipped around, holding the dagger up again. The vipers seemed to be coming in swarms, and as soon as you killed one, another one would appear. Butterfly had to jump in a few times and finish off one that was sliding in to take a bite from the side of you, but before long you'd almost reached your 10-snake goal. You were about to take out another viper when Butterfly quickly whipped his chain out and shattered the snake instantly. Butterfly, why did you get behind me, On, and stay close? He said suddenly and lowly. Why, what is it? You asked. Just then you heard a growl and looked over to the bushes nearby. You could see the red eyes of a wolf. Is that a wolf? You asked as you sidled in behind Butterfly. Yes, and there are a few, he replied quietly, still looking around. You glanced to your left and right, then behind you. Butterfly, I think we're surrounded, you said in a shaky voice. Don't be afraid, On, he said gently, placing his left hand around behind him to hold you against his back, his sword in his right hand. I won't let anything happen to you. You gripped your hands into Butterfly's cloak and pulled yourself against his back. Come, Butterfly suddenly commanded, and almost as if on cue the first wolf jumped out. It charged straight for Butterfly, but was decapitated instantly, so the next two wolves tried their luck and got the same treatment. All the while, Butterfly kept his left arm wrapped around behind himself, holding your body against his back as he fought a pack of wolves single-handedly. Butterfly behind you! You screamed as you looked back and saw five wolves stalking up behind the two of you. He stepped lightly around you and in one strike had taken out all five wolves. Well, okay, so now I know how he leveled up so quickly, you thought as he effortlessly took out multiple wolves at once. At last, the last wolf was taken care of and Butterfly let you go and turned to face you, lifting his hood so he could look you over properly. Are you okay, On? He asked as his eyes scanned your health bar, then your face. I'm 100% fine, thanks to you, you replied dreamily. God, I think I'm in love, you thought. Can I just say, that was so amazing. You just took out a pack of wolves single-handedly, like actually single-handedly, as in with one hand. Butterfly blushed. Oh, it's not that amazing, he replied with a small smile. I beg to differ, you replied with a snort. Anyway, On, it's getting late. We should maybe head back now. What time is it in the real world? You checked your menu. It's 8 p.m, you announced. Would you like to get dinner with me? Butterfly asked. We can eat at Dawn Restaurant. Sure, you replied happily. I have enough money for food. I was gonna buy you dinner, he said, averting his eyes and scratching his cheek shyly. So, kind of like a in-game date, you asked shyly. Yeah, if that's okay, Butterfly replied softly. Oh my god, a date with Butterfly! Yes, you said bluntly. You didn't know what else to say. Really? Butterfly responded, slightly shocked. That's great. Okay, let's go. You smiled stupidly and followed him out of the forest and back across the field to the inn. Hey, I'm curious though, you said as you trotted a little to catch up beside him. Why would you want to have a date with me? Well, he said softly, I haven't had this much fun in a long time. It's been refreshing to hang out with you. I just wanted to show you how much I like you before I have to go. Go? You asked, your heart sinking. What do you mean by go? I have to go back to level 43 and take on a particularly hard boss to unlock the next level, he said sadly. We were meeting down here a few days ago to discuss how best to tackle the monster. Oh, yeah, I remember, you said glumly. The lead guild is called Overthrow of Fate. Swiftkill is their leader. Ugh, yes, I remember that asshole, you said coldly. Wait, hang on, that guild, what do they call it for short? Overthrow F, Butterfly replied. No, The acronym would be OOF, wouldn't it? You said with a smirk. Butterfly grimaced. Yeah, they don't like being called OOF, hence why they call themselves Overthrow F. You cackled. Oh, this is just too good. So, is Swiftkill going to come back and get you before the fight with the monster? God, I hope so. I am so going to give him a hard time about being the leader of OOF. I don't like him either, but I have to work with him, unfortunately, Butterfly said sadly. Please don't make it any harder for me. Okay, for your sake I won't say anything, you said, looking at him with a smile. He looked back at you and smiled gently. Thank you, On. Everyone watched as you and Butterfly entered the restaurant, and the boss gave you a raised eyebrow when he saw you with the player who had caught your interest. You poked your tongue out at him playfully and he smirked. You and Butterfly had a lovely meal together and chatted about RFO mainly. You found out that he had chosen the name Butterfly with a 3 on the end because the original username he wanted wasn't available. He didn't really elaborate any further. You told him you'd decided that you wanted to become a merchant with your own shop, then swap to blacksmith when you'd gotten to a higher level. Butterfly's eyes lit up. That would be really great if you became a blacksmith, he said happily. I would use you for the maintenance of my equipment. What level are you now? I don't know. I did get notifications, but I just closed them without reading them, you replied sheepishly. He walked around the table to beside you, and you swiped your menu open, allowing him to scan through your details. Oh, you've just hit level 4, he said. At level 10, you can become a merchant, and then at level 40, you can swap to blacksmith. And there ends chapter 15. Stay tuned for chapter 16.